Besides walking around the log filming all the knots. You got some good video of that log? All right, I gotta figure out how much I wanna cut off in this first couple cuts. So this is a big pine log. Ah. Oh yeah. That might have done it. I think I can get by it. So, big heavy pine log. And it is big. Let me get my tape measure, I'll measure this. So at this end, up and down, 24 inch, across in the direction we're cutting, 17 inch. Down at this end, up and down, and I'm gonna go to the top of this knot here. 35 inch, and at the widest point, 31. Down here, at 24. So we ought to be able to get 24 inch wide slabs out of the center pieces of this. Don't know what they're gonna look like. This is gonna be some goofy patterns in this wood. But we'll see. When I saw these logs, I had to get them. Because, I mean, this is my kind of log. So, I got my cooking oil. This is what Ervin said to use. right, so I did that with no water. Look at this blade. I mean, there's a little bit of pitch on it. Get it on film. Don't just look.
Sorry.
All right. I'm going to try and pull these off. See if we got a flat cut, because cutting pine, this is the hard part, is getting a nice flat cut. Look at this bark. Bark's going on the fire. I'm not saving it for anyone. All right. That's a cool piece of wood.
Yeah.
Try and stand this up for you. And that's a heavy piece of wood. That's kind of neat. You can smell the pine. All right, Mary, this one's yours. Tony's gonna be mad. It's solid. Get my stick, I'll scrape that off. We can take a look at what we got here. There, you want me to do that? I can get up higher. So it's just bullseyes everywhere. Now, to get this, I'm standing on the sawmill and I'm holding the camera up about as high as I can. That's bark there, bark inclusion. That'll be pretty. So I can't see what I'm shooting with the camera. Oh man, I'm afraid of falling here. So, there you go. That's what we got so far. That is flat. Still flat. I got a little bit of a rise there. Can you see this gap here? There's a little bit of a dip right there. It's not much. And the rest of that cut was flat. Through super knotty pine that's, I'll have to measure how wide that is, probably about 30 inches wide. Man, that's some tough cutting. I could feel these knots as I was cutting through. They're pushing back. Oh, man. Yeah, that's a big slab. I didn't realize this was that long. Ah. So, when I'm doing this alone, this is how I do it, which is crazy, but it works. Yep, that's gonna struggle. Because the edges of this are not straight. Here, let me try and pull that back. I'm gonna have to put that end on there first. The knots are catching. See this one right here? Yep. It's catching. So by doing that, I get over it. Watch it, this end's gonna make some noise. And there you go. Got it on there. All right, that's an actual straight edge. So you can see a little bit of daylight here and there, but it's like a 16th of an inch. Let's move down further. Push some of the sawdust off. There is a little bit of washboard effect. But for the most part, that's pretty flat. There's a little bit of daylight there, but I mean, if that's all I'm getting with all these knots,
not bad.
That looks awesome. These are flat slabs. So Marvin was right. That oil helps. Yeah. He also said use a really sharp blade, so I'm gonna change the blade. So, all right, so we put a new blade on. I gotta tension it still, make sure it's got the right tension. And then we're gonna take another cut. I did the new blade now, just to make sure that I don't get any wavy cuts, so. Oh, yeah. And that's tensioned good. Wow, so on this side, my blade guide, this thing, right here,
yep,
rubbed on the log as I went by the one knot. That's how far out that log came on that side. That was a full cut. You couldn't have gotten any wider. Fun. Holy crap. Oh, that's heavy. That's got to weigh 200 pounds at least. That's a 12-foot pine slab, probably an average of 33 inches wide and 2.5 inches thick. That's big for me. Matt Cremona would be laughing at me, but hell, he's a young guy. You can get up there and stand on the log if you want. This is what Uncle Ed is willing to do for you guys to get a shot. Yeah, I'm gonna have to help you down. This is beautiful wood. Look at that. Wow. That's like a three-dimensional pattern in there. It is three-dimensional. I feel little ridges. All right, I'm gonna step over on this side, Ed. All right, I'm gonna try and scrape this off. All right, he got the standing. Just watch where you walk and don't fall. Wow, that's some pretty stuff. Look at that. That really is. Pine? For pine?
Yeah.
All right, here, give me the camera and you come on down. There's a step here you can use. Right here, I get down by the tire. Just sit on the edge and put your feet down. All right, Uncle Ed is getting his exercise. That's backwards. All right, let's see if it's flat. Are we taking any bets? Oh yeah, look at that. That's like perfect.
Seriously.
All right, let's slide down. It's still perfect. Let's slide down. Hey, Ervin. Check this out. I keep thinking Marvin, because Marvin was the guy down the road here. Marvin Detweiler had a sawmill. All right, water splash. So here's the end I'm going to stand on. So you can see that. You can see that three-dimensional. GoPro, stop tilting. He's almost dead. There's that three-dimensional stuff. I'll show you better down here. Right here, you can see it really good there. Right, these lines coming out, that is so cool.
It is.
And there's the end of the log. So to give you a view from the skinny end, Looking down, that's what it looks like. That'll give you size. That's a foot. So it's 2 foot wide. All right, so while I was changing the GoPro battery, Uncle Ed was wandering around and he spotted my other log. So he wanted me to get a shot of that. So this log we're cutting, it was the top half of the tree. This log over here, this is the bottom half of the tree, so it's bigger. I couldn't even lift this one with my skid steer. I'm gonna have to shorten it. It's, I think it's 12 foot long. So this is the bottom end of the one that we're cutting. This is on the big end of the one we're cutting, goes on here. And then the log continues from there. You can see this was a big tree. And then here's the very bottom, which I can cut off so it's nice and square and flat. That's the log. So that one is gonna be, that's gonna make some big slabs. I'm gonna need 3 people here to do that. And then this is a nice maple crotch log. Just to give you an idea of size, that's a big log. So those are coming. They're in. Let me see how far I gotta go, because I gotta center this like within an inch. Oh, that's good there. The other end's got to come this way. I think I can move that by hand if I hold this with the skid steer. Hang on.
Ready?
Yep. Woo! That lifted me up.
The corner.
It doesn't matter. Just hit it any way you can. You're going to have to lay it down more. All right, get out of the way. Wow, that's big. That's a big slab.
Leverage.
Yeah. All right, battery's dying, so we got them all on the skidster. There's 8 slabs. I thought we were gonna die stacking these on here, but they're pretty cool. That's the camera on the roof. The battery just went dead. So you can see the top slab was really the end of the log. Oh, yeah. But we got them. That's some cool edges for a live edge slab. And it's live edge on both sides, so if you don't want to cut one side off, there's some good slabs there. Look at that. There's the pith centered perfectly in that slab. All right, so they said a bright sunny day, but it's starting to rain. So I'm gonna move this log put it away, put the sawmill away so it doesn't get too wet. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Yeah, it's pouring down rain and you can see it coming off the roof. Sawmill's getting soaked. The wood is getting soaked. Look at this. I mean, it is just torrential. This is ridiculous. They said it wasn't gonna rain. How come weathermen don't get fired when they're wrong?